Welcome to a lesson in which we'll compare linear growth and exponential growth. We'll also write recursive and explicit equations for both linear and exponential growth. We have now discussed recursive and explicit formulas for linear and exponential growth separately. Now let's compare the two side by side. For linear growth, if a quantity starts at size p sub 0 and grows by d units every time period, then the quantity after n time periods can be determined using either of these two equations here. We have a recursive equation and an explicit equation. For the recursive equation, notice that p sub n is based upon the previous population of p sub n minus 1. So the recursive equation for linear growth is p sub n equals p sub n minus 1 plus d, again where d is our common difference. And we can use this formula here to find d if needed. For linear growth, the explicit equation is p sub n equals p sub 0 plus d times n. For the explicit equation, we can find p sub n directly knowing the value of n. For exponential growth, if a quantity starts at size p sub 0 and grows by r percent every time period, then the quantity after n time periods can be determined using either of these two equations. Again, we have a recursive equation and an explicit equation. For exponential growth, the recursive equation is p sub n equals the quantity 1 plus r times p sub n minus 1. Again, we can find the quantity 1 plus r, the growth multiplier, using this formula here. Notice how if we know the growth multiplier, we can also determine r. The explicit equation for exponential growth is p sub n equals p sub 0 times the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of n. So for linear growth, the population is growing by d units every time period. And for exponential growth, the population is growing by r percent each time period. As an example, a herd of elk has a population of 500. After 1 month, there are 600 elk. Write an explicit growth formula for linear growth and exponential growth. So we'll use the same information to come up with two equations, one based on linear growth and one based on exponential growth. Since the starting population is 500, we can say p sub 0 equals 500. And if n is the number of months, we can say p sub 1, the population after 1 month, is 600. We can use this information to write both equations. For linear growth, we'll have p sub n equals p sub 0 plus d times n. So we'll begin by determining d, the common difference. So if n is 1, notice how this would be p sub 1 minus p sub 0, or in our case, 600 minus 500, which is equal to 100. And therefore, the explicit equation for linear growth would be p sub n equals 500 plus 100 times n. For exponential growth, we have p sub n equals p sub 0 times the quantity 1 plus r raised to the power of n. So we'll begin by determining the growth multiplier, which is 1 plus r, using this formula here. Again, if n is 1, we have p sub 1 divided by p sub 0, which would be 600 divided by 500, which gives us 1.2. Notice how if the growth multiplier is 1.2, we should recognize that r would be 0.2, therefore the growth rate would be 20% each time period. So the exponential growth equation would be p sub n equals 500 times 1.2 raised to the power of n. Now let's extrapolate or make predictions into the future using both models. So here's our linear model and here's our exponential model. First, notice how p sub 0 and p sub 1 are the same for both models because that was the given information. But each time period for linear growth, notice how the population increases by 100, and for exponential growth, the population increases by 20% each time period. Notice for linear growth, as n increases by 1 each time, the population increases by 100. If we wanted to, we could also express this using a recursive formula, where we'd have p sub n equals p sub n minus 1 plus 100. Now comparing this to exponential growth, notice as n increases by 1 each time, we're multiplying by another factor of 1.2. So comparing the two models, notice from year 2 through year 4, the populations are no longer the same because, once again, this is linear growth and this is exponential growth. If we wanted to write the recursive formula for exponential growth, we would have p sub n equals 1.2 times p sub n minus 1. Now let's compare the graphs of these two explicit equations. The blue line represents the linear growth, and the red curve represents the exponential growth. Comparing the graphs, if we assume exponential growth, we can see the population would increase much faster than if we assume linear growth. Now let's take a look at two more examples. We want to state whether each situation is linear or exponential. Write both the recursive and explicit formulas for the situation, then finally answer the question. The population of Flagstaff is increasing at a rate of 1,300 people per year. If the population is 66,000 now, what will it be in 5 years? So the key to identifying linear or exponential growth is determining how the population is changing each unit of time. Notice how it's increasing at a rate of 1,300 people per year, and since the population is increasing by a constant amount, not a constant percent each time period, this is linear growth. Which means to write the recursive and explicit formulas, we'll be using these two formulas here, where the common difference is going to be 1,300. So if D equals 1,300, then our recursive formula, P sub n, would be equal to P sub n minus 1 plus 1,300. Meaning to find the population after n years, we take the population of the previous year and add 1,300. And now for the explicit equation, we would have P sub n equals P sub 0, the starting population of 66,000, and then plus D times n, which would be 1,300. Times n. Now if I had to answer the question to find the population in 5 years, we want to find P sub 5. Using the explicit equation, we would have 66,000 plus 1,300 times 5. This would be 66,000 plus 6,500. So the predicted population would be 72,500 people. Let's take a look at number 2. The value of a new car depreciates 20% per year. If you purchase a new car for $18,000, how much will it be worth in 5 years? Here, notice how the value is decreasing at a constant percent each year. When something is increasing or decreasing at a constant percent, not a constant amount, this is an example of an exponential model. In this case, because the value is going down, we can say it's exponential decay. If it was going up, we could say exponential growth. And because it's going down by 20% each year, r would be negative 20% expressed as a decimal. So if r is equal to negative 20%, that would be negative 0.2. Therefore, 1 plus r, the multiplier, would be 1 plus negative 0.2, or 0.8. And hopefully this does make sense. If the car loses 20% of its value each year, it retains 80% of the value each year. And now for the exponential recursive formula here, we would have p sub n equals 0.8 times p sub n minus 1. And the explicit exponential equation would be p sub n equals p sub 0, the starting value of the car, which is 18,000, times the quantity 1 plus r, which we know is 0.8 raised to the power of n. So to find the value of the crop after 5 years, we want to find p sub 5, which should be 18,000 times 0.8 raised to the power of 5. Now we'll go to the calculator. The value of the car would be $5,898.24. I hope you found this helpful.